Hey everyone, I'm Alex Noonan, and I'm a developer advocate here at Dagster Labs. So processing documents is something that's done at every organization. In my first job out of college, I spent a good portion of my day loading contract information into our operational database. Extracting text from a PDF is a solved problem technologically. You can either pay for a managed service, or you can use a Python-based open source solution. Now, to build your own solution, that requires technical resources to build, test, and maintain. And often within organizations, that's just difficult to prioritize. And that's why we built components. There's so many teams out there have such specific organizational contexts where it's difficult to have a tool that can meet the users where they are while still adhering to software engineering best practices and having all of your organizational context embedded into the tool as well. Components allows you to ship faster, and it's low code that doesn't suck. Today, I will be doing a demo where I build a custom component to extract text from a PDF and then verify that it has all the information we need using OpenAI. And the link for this project will be in the description if you want to follow along. But without further ado, let's hop into VS Code. I want to create a new Dagster project using our new DG CLI. So first I want to make sure that DG is installed. So I'm going to check the version. All right, it looks like we're good. Now let's check to see what commands we have here. So we're probably gonna wanna initialize a new Dagster project for this. So let's do that real quick. Init, enter a name. We're gonna call this PDF extraction. Yeah, sure, let's UV sync this. All right, let us navigate to the new project, and then we're going to activate the virtual environment. All right, so let's take a look at our project. So we have the TOML file, the UV lock. These are like the project configuration files. We have a tests folder, and we have a source folder that has our definitions file, our definitions folder, the library here, which has any of our custom plugins or components. And then we have our virtual environment folder. And what is cool about this project structure, anything you load into the defs file will be automatically loaded. So it's a lot cleaner to add new definitions to your Dagster project. So I want to build a custom component for this PDF extraction because I'm going to have less technical stakeholders come into this project. I just want them to be able to add the directory of their PDFs and do some simple config in a YAML file to get their pipeline stood up. So we're going to use components for that. Let's check, go back to our CLI. So we are scaffolding our custom component type. Boom, and like I said, it's right in here. And then we have our boilerplate here to build our custom component. The build definitions function is like the main process within this component structure. And it is very similar to our asset factory method. It's like an improved version of it. And here it'll create any of the Dagster abstractions, assets, resources, jobs, scheduled. You can build them all here. So it'll take a structured input and then fill out all those entities. We're going to add a new file in here for a PDF extraction resource. So let's go through this file real quick so we can understand what's happening. So we have our PDF extractor configurable resource here. It takes in language, DPI, our OpenAI key, and then an output directory. We authenticate with OpenAI. All right, so the first function here is for pre-processing. And that's where we clean up the image, sharpen it up, increase the contrast so we can get the most out of our text extraction. And then we're converting the PDF into PNG files. And finally, we're extracting the text from those images. And then we have a validation check. And since the PDFs we're working with here are purchase orders, I can create a structured prompt to send to OpenAI to validate that the PDF has all the right headers here. And similar sort of thing over here, we have our PDF extraction component. So this component provides a complete PDF extraction pipeline where it converts images, extracts the text, and then does a validation. And then these values here are the input parameters for your components. You can set default values. The asset specs is how you assign Dagster associated metadata to them, like their asset group, their owner, that type of thing. And then, like I mentioned earlier, we have this build defs function, which takes in all the PDFs in a directory, initializes a PDF extractor resource that we created earlier for each PDF in that folder, converts to an image, extracts the text, makes an asset check, and then defines a job for that specific PDF, and then creates a job for all the PDFs. And then it returns all the definitions. And then for the scaffolder, this class right here creates a YAML templated file based off that component we just created. If when I'm explaining this to you, this sounds pretty complicated, that's because it is. And the benefit of using components is me as the senior data engineer, the data platform owner, can write all this complex Python logic, embed it into our Dagster project. And if a less technical stakeholder needs to unblock themselves, they can just hop into this Dagster project, generate the docs, and then create a component in YAML. And so for the next step, I'm going to simulate what that would be like to come into this Dagster project and try and create a custom component. Let's list the components that we have here. All right, so we have that PDF lib extraction. And then one of the cool things with components is you can generate docs. So let's launch these. Yeah, so we have our Dagster-based components here, and then we have the custom one that we wrote. So here we have all that documentation we created, and we can copy this command to scaffold our own. And then it also explains the input parameters and what an example YAML file would look like. And this is just like a much easier developer experience. So we're gonna copy the command here, and we are going to scaffold a new PDF extraction component. And we'll call these purchase orders. And then right here we have our templated component. And then another great thing about the local DG workflow, it's a lot more ergonomic. So you can see what assets you have, you can validate them, and then you can run them all in the command line, which will save you a ton of time instead of loading up the UI. So let's list our definitions. And let's launch that asset to make sure it works properly. Let's fire up the UI and run the whole process. Let's take a look at our asset graph real quick. So we have the first PDF asset. So we have the first PDF process right here and then the second one below. And let's go over to jobs and process all PDFs. All right, so like the conversion. So these assets materialize pretty fast. The asset check will take some time, usually around like 10 to 15 seconds. But these PDFs are pretty simple, so it shouldn't be too hard for this process to work effectively. And then let's take a look at our asset checks. So it looks like it found all of the information that we wanted it to find. We didn't have any errors, but we had a few missing sections. So that's something we can take a look at manually, but overall the quality was high enough for it to pass. I hope you enjoyed that tutorial about building custom components and a quick introduction to our DG CLI. Now, if you want to learn more about components, our CTO and founder, Nick Schrock, recently did a webinar where he explained like where we see components going and how it's going to revolutionize how data engineers and data platform owners enable teams to contribute to their data platform while still adhering to Dagster and data engineering best practices. Thank you.